Hi, welcome again to our series, My Friend the Holy Spirit. I'm Gift Zawadi Love. The last time we talked about reporting to duty, I want to share a scripture with you in Joshua 5:13-15. And it came to pass when Joshua was by Jericho that he lifted his eyes and looked, and behold, a man stood opposite him with his sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua went to him and said to him, "Are you for us or for our adversaries?" So he said, "No, but as commander of the army of the Lord, I have now come." And Joshua fell on his face to the earth and worshipped and said to him, "What does my Lord say to his servant?" Then the commander of the army of the Lord said to Joshua, "Take your sandals off your foot, for the place where you stand is holy." And Joshua did so. See, Joshua asked a very simple question when he saw the commander of the army of the Lord. "Are you for us or for our enemies?" And you understand that a commander of the army of the Lord, he said, "Neither. I'm not for you, nor for your enemies. I am on the Lord's side. I have come here as the commander of the army of the Lord. I have now come." Realize God doesn't take sides. You have to take his side. And when Joshua realized who he was speaking with, immediately he bowed down. He fell to his face on the earth and worshipped and said to him, "What does my Lord say to his servant?" See, Jesus is the commander of the army of the Lord. And he doesn't take sides. He's on God's side. So it's up to us to choose. Do we report to duty? Or do we just do what we want to do? Because he's not going to follow you. He's neither on your side and he's not on your enemy's side. He's on God's side and he stands with what the heavens says. So that's why we have to be very careful what we do and how we go about our lives, how we go about addressing God. It is not about us using him. It is him using us. We did not sign up for creation. I did not say I needed to be created. I did not command God to create me. There is a reason why he created us. And that reason, why don't we ask him? That he may be able to fulfill his assignments and his reasons for creating us through our yielding to him and through us being like Joshua, flat on our face, in humility and asking exact same thing. "What does my Lord say to his servant?" Report to duty. You know, if we see things through God's eyes, it becomes very simple. I one time told God, "You know, Daddy, I want to see things through your eyes. Because if I see what you see, then I will be able to bring that heaven, your will on earth as it is in heaven. If it is so dark, things are not working out. But then you say that it is light and things are working out. I speak what God speaks." Because remember, during creation, when God saw it was dark, he never acknowledged the darkness. He spoke what he wanted to see. In the same way, we are created not to acknowledge the situations that we see, not to acknowledge the things that are not of God, but to speak those things that are not as though they are, bringing them to pass. The Bible says that nothing was created. Everything that was created out of nothing. Why? He spoke it. When you speak, you are creating. When you look at your life and you see what you have created, look at how what you have spoken. Because power of life and death is in our tongue. The minute we see what God sees, then we can be able to speak what God speaks and things will come to pass. If you see the finances, you're struggling with finances or you're struggling with your health, what does God say about it? Find out what God says about it. What does God see? Then speak that which God sees. Because if you speak what he speaks, then you will be victorious. One day, I was asking the Lord something. And I wanted to know about a specific situation. And I went to my knees on my knees in prayer. And I was telling God, "Father, in Jesus' name." And I started praying about this situation. Immediately, God the Father stopped me and he said, "Wait a minute. What did I say about that situation?" I responded by what he had said. And he said, then why are you praying? All you have to do is speak it. The minute I knew that, I stopped praying and asking and begging because I knew his will. I spoke his will and it came to pass. Today, I dare you to speak the will of God in your life. Find out the will of God and speak it, and it shall come to pass. And you'll be victorious by bringing the kingdom of God on earth as it is in heaven. God bless you, and join us again. Thank you.